The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" Jesus replied, "The first is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." The scribe said to him, "Well said, teacher, you are right in saying he is one and there is no other than he. And to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices." And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Good morning, dear friends. Pakibati nga ng good morning din. A happy Thursday morning, our neighbor, seatmate. And also to our online parishioners, thank you also for being with us this Thursday. We are still in Mark chapter 12, continuation of what we have been reading for the past few days. In the chapter, we heard of Jesus having this dialogue, conversation, even argument with some groups of people. He was visited by the Herodians and the Pharisees, asking him about paying taxes to Rome or to Caesar. He was visited yesterday by the Sadducees, who also asked him about the afterlife or the resurrection. And today, another, not confrontation, but a beautiful conversation occurred in the gospel, this time with one of the scribes. Paliwanag natin, no? Noong una, pinaliwanag natin yung mga Sadduceo. Who are they? The Sadducees are the aristocrats, the rich people. The Pharisees are the so-called separated ones. They are the religious leaders. The scribes are the scholars of the law. Present day, pwede natin silang maihambing sa mga abogado, sa mga judges, those working in the legal profession. And the scribes, usually, they are all intellectual people. Ang unang trabaho ng scribe ay isulat yung Bible, at least at that time. They had no benefit of printing press. Wala pang mga printer nun. Kaya ang trabaho ng scribe ay siya yung magsusulat ng scriptures. And in order to do that, you must know what you are writing and you must have a good handwriting. Hindi kagaya ng handwriting ng mga doktor. Sorry sa mga doktor, no? So you must have a very beautiful handwriting and you must also know what you are writing. Even the smallest punctuation, you have to be very accurate because you are writing not just an ordinary book, you are writing the Word of God, transcribing it from one manuscript to another. That's how important the scribe was in their time. Sila yung nagsusulat until their role evolved. Because they are scholars, they know the law, so they became also the interpreters of the law. Sila yung nakakabisado yung salita ng Diyos, at least the Old Testament, at alam nila kung ano rin ang tamang interpretation ng mga sinulat nila. And eventually, they became very professional in what they were doing and everybody had to refer to them or defer to them when it comes to the law. So in other words, if you are dealing with a scribe, you are dealing with a very intellectual, intelligent person, a learned man, hindi mo siya pwedeng paikot-ikutin, at alam niya kung anong sinasabi niya. Pwedeng sila yung sabihin nating mga academics of their time. Pero alam natin na sa maraming mga pagkakataon, in many instances, Jesus had some arguments with the scribes, but not described in the gospel today. Jesus said to him after their dialogue, "You are not far from the kingdom. You understand what you are writing and what you are interpreting and teaching to the people. Indeed, you are not far from the kingdom." Later on in verse 38, the same chapter, chapter 12, he would denounce the scribes also. Why? Because many of the scribes were not like this scribe who understood what they were teaching. For the many scribes, it was all about for the show, for showing off to people how good or brilliant they are in terms of their scholarly works. But this scribe is different because he came to Jesus with a very basic question: what is the greatest commandment? And of course, Jesus responded to him also in a rather positive way, and they understood each other that indeed, at the end of it all, it is love. The greatest commandment is to love God above all with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and to love your neighbor as you love yourselves. So at the end of it all, love is the greatest of all the commandments. Why is this important to us today? Because so many times we are seeking God. We seek God and we look for God. And yes, there are so many of us who would like to serve God. Gusto naman nating paglingkuran ng Diyos. Gusto naman natin siyang makilala. Pero ang dulo ng lahat ng itong paghahanap at pagsasaliksik ay dapat dumating sa pagmamahal. At the end of it all, as Saint Therese of Lisieux would say, it is love that matters. Our vocation and calling is always to love. Saint Therese would often say that. Without love, even for the little things that you do in your life, if there is no love inside your heart, and all these things you do, they mean nothing. The language that God understands is not the language of the academic or the scholar. The language that God understands is the language of the heart, which is primarily love. This heart that I am wearing, symbolizing to us the sacred heart of Jesus, this is all that matters for God. Sabi rin ni San Pablo yun, what if you are the smartest of all? Or what if you have gained the whole world? But if you have no love in your heart, you're just an empty gong or an empty, a noisy gong and an empty cymbal that makes sounds but nothing inside, nothing to show from the inside because there is no love. It should be clear to us today, dear friends, that the greatest commandment, not just something to be followed, but something to live by, is love. Pag wala nang pag-ibig, wala nang saysay lahat ng ginagawa natin. And yesterday, we were very sad because one of our priests, and I think you know naman what happened yesterday, it was even in the news, no? All over. And we felt very sad about it. Isang pare, isang bishop na nagkaroon ng ganitong altercation, nagkaroon ng ganong... We were just saying to ourselves, this should not be. This is not who we are. You know? Pag pari ka, nilagay ka sa isang parokya, you know, you're meant to stay there to serve and to love. You're not put there in order to, you know what I'm talking about. And I think if we lose that love inside us, then we will become very cruel with one another. Hindi ba tayo nagkakaintindihan? Ay, sorry ha. Buti na lang hindi kayo mga marites, no? At chismosa. And good for you, good for you, good for you. Pero it was really a conversation among us last night, no? Among us priests. Na bakit may ganito sa atin sa simbahan? It should not be like that, no? We were meant, doon sa mga hindi nakakalam, imamarites ko na lang sa inyo. Mayroong isang news item kahapon sa GMA, I think, or what. Tapos may video na pinakita, nakesyo yung isang bishop, tinulak yung isang pare, and then there was this argument, away sila. Hindi ko alam kung nagsabunutan, pero... yeah, and then I felt very bad about it, honestly, to be honest with you. Very bad about it because this is not who we are. This is not what we are supposed to be. And parish life, no? To be a parish priest is not the be-all, end-all of our life, no? Pag sinabi ng bishop sa'yo na, Father, you get out of your assignment, you go. You just go. You don't have to question your bishop. Yung parang ganun. So, anyway. So, nailabas ko lang yung aking saloobin dyan. Pero, wag na ho kayo mag-search sa Facebook. Pero, syempre, dadaan naman sa newsfeed nyo yan, ano? Pero, might as well talk about it. And I think the proper context of that is, let us look everything in the eyes of love. If this is not love anymore, then this is not godly anymore. This is not about Christ anywhere. And this is what St. Paul was saying to Timothy in the first reading, his beloved. Ganda ng sinabi ni St. Paul kay Timothy. Sabi niya, son, spiritual son niya si Timothy. Remember, beloved Timothy, remember, the gospel I proclaim is Jesus Christ. Not a doctrine, not a teaching. What I preach as a gospel is Jesus, the person of Jesus, whom I dearly love. And I'm ready to lay down everything for Him. If we have died with Him, we shall also live with Him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with Him. If we deny Him, He will deny us. If we are unfaithful, He remains faithful to us. So at the end of it all, again, John of the Cross, Saint John of the Cross would say, at the twilight of our life, we shall all be judged on one measuring stick alone. At the twilight of our life, we shall be judged on love alone. I, as a priest, I will not be judged on what I have constructed in the parish or what I have built, what I have done. No, I will be measured by God on the kind of love that I shared with people. At the end of it all, it is this heart that would matter. The Sacred Heart of Jesus reminds all of us the greatest commandment is love. The scribes, and let me end with them, the scribes, they were very intellectual, but they did not have a heart. Many of them at least. So Jesus was so happy to encounter this scribe who had a heart. And Jesus told him, you are not far from the kingdom, my friend. You are a scholar of the law, but you understand very well what is the essence and the heart of it all. You are not far from the kingdom. Hopefully, Jesus can also say that to us in our life. Kapatid, go on. You are not far from the kingdom. You are not yet there. You are not yet there, but you are moving towards the kingdom as long as there is love in your heart. Pwede po ba yun? Heart, heart, heart po tayo. Araw-araw, yun. Heart, heart, heart lang. Kasi pag wala ng puso, ano pang parakay pa? Parakay pa ginagawa natin yung mga bagay sa araw-araw. So put love in it, put your heart in it, and that's all that matters. You succeed or not, it doesn't matter. As long as you have put your heart, your love into it. Something done out of love will always be look at by God as you are not far from the kingdom. If there is love, you are not far from the kingdom of the heart of Jesus. Praised be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Let us pray. Governed by your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, those you feed with the body and blood of your Son, that professing you, not just in word or in speech, but also in works and in truth, we may merit to enter the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Magandang umaga po ulit sa inyo lahat. Thank you very much for coming to Mass, and also to our online parishioners, thank you for praying with us. Again, friends, nothing will make sense if there is no love in it. If love is not in the heart, then anything we do or say, it doesn't make sense. It will never be near to the path of the kingdom. So the nearest path to the kingdom is the way of love. Let's try to do that every day, to become lovers of God and to become lovers and beloved to one another. So after the Mass, we will have our healing prayer through the relic of Santa Maria Goretti in St. Ezekiel, and also Sister Flora, my partner in the healing ministry in the parish, is with us also. So she would also like to pray for us, intercede for our behalf. And I'd like to greet one of our most ardent followers in the online, Sister Corazon Andaya. It is her birthday today, and we are praying also for her daughter, Luan. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our loving God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.